did a training the other day. And I decided not to ride to work. And I kind of decided that when I ride, I prefer it to be dry weather, and so I can go at a speed that I'm comfortable with, rather than feeling like I'm holding back. So I know that if I'm riding in the rain, everything's going to have to be cut down. I mean, I can't go nuts, or at least go at a speed that I'm used to going on the dry. So that kind of holding back doesn't seem very fun to me, so I don't know. I mean, if it rains one weekend, I also didn't want to take the risk of maybe my inexperience causing me to crash on the way to work. I know it's pretty unlikely, but I didn't want to take that risk of being late for work. So I said, all right, if it rains on the weekend, then I'll go out to some place and practice a little bit in the wet. Or if I go down, it won't really matter as much. So let's pick up the bike and go home or whatever. It's a nice viewpoint here. I'll stop for a moment. Kickstand down. Now, these guys aren't slow. This is the Ferrari group. Sucks, my iPod just turned off. Okay, I've got a close. Technically, you have to hit the kill switch first, but whatever. There it goes. Yeah, see? Fucking stupid cord. I don't want to get stuck behind any really slow-moving cars here. gas. Still over 100 miles on the trip meter. And at this point, I'm trying to think about selling the Ninja, the 250. It really is a backup bike for when I ditch this one. But I have no intention of ditching this bike or crashing it ever. I think once was enough. And I just can't really get excited about riding my Ninja 250 as much. I read on a forum one time that 5,000 miles, the first 5,000 miles when you get a new bike or a different bike, that's a dangerous phase. In the first 2,000 you'll ride kind of conservatively, and then after 2,000 to 5,000 you start to enter this area where you feel confident and comfortable, but your skills aren't high enough on that bike yet. And you get complacent like I did and go down. I'm over 5,000 on both bikes. I'm getting to the point where I'm starting to get a little, delinquent on working on the 250. I don't want to end up, the bike be like sitting around for too long and then trying to sell it to somebody. And then telling them, oh, it's been sitting around for a long time, so I don't know how good it is or not. I still have to do the 0 to 60 uphill thing on the Ninja 250, so I made a request about that. I still want to do that.